The main thing to worry about here are the brackets for the new spotlight. I need to mark and drill the holes in the body, but I will go to an extra bit of trouble and paint the exposed metal and stop rust in the future. It is possible to mount the spotlights on the bumpers, but this way is stronger and it looks better. The bumper is one of Mike's purchases, and because it uses all the original hangers, it's easy to fit. And now to give the mark on its face. I resprayed the dog bone grille in satin black. It helps to make the front of the car look factory fresh. There's always a great call from Mark 1 fans to fit four spots on the front, and our twin light system is bordering on controversial, but I like it. Fitting is simple enough, but the wiring does need some slight modification, an additional relay and a switch on the dash. And now all the chrome trim, such a key part of this car, is in place. When Mike bought this car, it seemed as though there are only a few details to change. But the more you do, the more you find you need to do. And the new door cards, carpets and retrimming on the rear seat set me back £700, which is more or less what the car costs new. I sourced a new dash panel from a specialist and I'm putting on Mike's cool steering wheel. Now for some new front seatage found online. A pair of new mirrors, and a set of 13-inch wheels that Mike got with the car as part of the deal. No, they're not alloys, but after some careful repainting, they look wonderful and give our Wheeler Dealers Mark 1 special the final touch of elegance.
Click here to subscribe.